Hey everybody, welcome into another lacrosse matchup preview. I'm Olivia Becker, joined by Patrick Strawn, and we're gonna look back first at the Battle for Baltimore lacrosse tournament. First, they played Oregon, and that seemed to be a pretty close game. They won by 2 goals for that game. Can you just touch a little bit on how that went for them?
Yeah, it was. It was really an exciting matchup. Obviously, the first time the Flames ever faced Oregon Ducks, and it lived up to the hype. Obviously, Oregon got up really quick, up and early on the Flames, but then the Flames battled back, showing off that balanced attack and also solid defense. But then Oregon once again crept back into the game, and it really became a shootout between the two, but the Flames were able to pull it out because of the fact that their firepower, I think, was just a little bit too much for the Ducks to handle. And that big run that they were able to take in the second quarter, they were able to hold on to the lead, and as you said, yeah, able to pull out a win by 2 goals.
And the next game, they played Northeastern, and that game seemed to be a little bit bigger of a gap in goals. They won by 4-5. However much that was. So talk a little bit about how that game went for them.
Well, I think for them, I think that was a better execution of what they were hoping for in that matchup against Northeastern. Obviously, the Huskies, once again, they brought their A game and they really came to the table and obviously tested the Flames early. But then the Flames really did, as we touched on, were able to showcase that balanced attack. 7 different goal scorers in that matchup. And in Oregon, only 6. So obviously, one other person was able to contribute. And obviously, the Flames were just getting it done across the board. And I think that's a huge factor for them. I mean, we keep talking about this balanced attack for them, and obviously when you're able to have so many different guys, they're able to put the ball in the back of the net, as we just said, 7 different guys were able to contribute on the scoring end. That's just going to pave the way for you and make you really dangerous against any team you're facing. Flames were able to be dangerous against the Huskies.
And they're really going to need to be dangerous because they have one of their biggest games coming up this Saturday, playing South Carolina. And one thing we've touched on the most through these previews is how well-rounded the team has been this year. How do you think that is going to help them going into this huge game for them?
Well, I think the biggest thing for them is really that they're going to have to find a way to obviously stifle this powerful balanced attack also in South Carolina. The Gamecocks really put it to the Flames last year, beating them in the 2 matchups that they put them against, beating them once on their home turf in South Carolina and then in the SCLC Championship. So I know a lot of guys on the Flames roster have this date circled on their calendar. They've been waiting to get a little payback in their own home field. So it'll be an exciting matchup. Unfortunately, we won't be able to be there because we're on the road. But it will be one that I think people, if you're in the area, you have to take a look at and also tune into, because it will be a matchup, top 10 matchup between two of the best in the SCLC and also in the nation. I expect a pretty high scoring game because of the fact that both teams' offenses are very balanced and very potent, but also you're going to see a lot of saves and also a lot of defensive play too on both ends of the ball, so it will be an exciting one in Lynchburg.
Yes, and like he said, you can tune in finally. We got everything working back again. So make sure you guys tune into the game, check social media, check the website and everything, and tune in Saturday for that game. For Patrick Strom, I'm Olivia Becker.